Devin in Dallas. Devin of Dallas. Hi.
Hi. I am so, oh my God, my heart is racing. You don't remember me, but you remember, I know you'll remember my mother, Charmaine Goodalay, the artist.
Your mother is one of my favorite living human beings.
Yes. When I was younger and snarky teenager, she tried getting
me. Wait. Let me just say something. Snarky teenager is redundant. So either say teenager or snarky.
When I was a teenager, she would get me to try and watch your YouTube videos and listen to you. And I really regret that I didn't open my eyes sooner. But I listen to you every day.
Wow.
And you were just, oh my gosh, I'm so nervous right now. I didn't even think I'd get through. But anyways.
All right, hold on. There's a break. I want you to say everything you have on your mind so that, everything you had on your mind to call in with. All right, everybody, this is the hour you call in on anything in the world, and we go back to our 20-year-old who was once a snarky teenager, though it's hard to believe because she sounds terrific, and Devin in Dallas. So go ahead.
So I currently live in Texas, and I'm about to finish up school and get my bachelor's degree this summer. And so I was kind of faced with the decision. When I came to Texas, I had the honor of meeting a beautiful man who I have been dating for 4 years now, and he is a firefighter, and he is he's remarkable. And his family is amazing, and they have taken me in as one of their own, because my mother and my siblings and my whole entire family lives back in Arizona. And so the conversation of getting married came up, and he told me that he does not want to move to Arizona and that he will not move to Arizona. And there's no possibility of my family moving to Texas. So I'm faced with going to be with my family and my mother, who I love and respect and as an adult has become my best friend. And I cannot fathom being away from her and having, babies without her and starting a family without her right down the street. And so, happiness is such an important, such an important value. And I don't want to be unhappy. But how do you make an impossible decision like that?
Well, you're making it hard on me because I have such an adoration for your mom. But my general belief is that it's easier to hop on an airplane than it is to find a good man.
Mm-hmm. You make it sound so simple.
In life, many times the right thing or the better thing, right thing is not the better word, the better solution or the solution is simple. What is extremely difficult is to execute the decision. It's not that hard. Sometimes it's very hard to know what the right thing to do is. But most of the time, it's hard to execute the right thing, to do the right thing, not to know what it is. I'm very biblically based. A man shall leave his mother and father and cling to his wife, and they shall be as one flesh. And I believe it applies to both sexes. And it will bring your mother immense joy when, God willing, you will have children and you will have a good, if you have a good marriage and good children, that's rather big for a parent. Look, I identify with your mother. My son who has children as a child lives in Miami, far farther from LA than Dallas is from Phoenix. And I use Skype a lot and travel a lot, and I wish they lived next door. What can I say? But I rather have my son with a good woman, which he has, and a good family life far away than not have the right woman close by. And that's the...
have completely eased my heart, and I hope you know that coming from you is, even though it's hard to hear, and you know, you wish you could have it the exact way you wanted it. I value your opinion so much, and I think
that's why it was difficult for me to say it, because I know that, and because of my adoration for your mom. Is she still painting?
Yes, she is.
How is she? I want to give her a free plug here. She has done. I hired her to do a painting, and it's a great thing. With all the dear friend of mine, I put all the loves of his life, all his passions of life, into the painting, and she made it. He is the only time in life I saw him cry. How do people get in touch with your mom?
You can look her up at Charmaine Goudelet, and she has, you know, she has a Facebook, and I know she has.
How do you spell the last name?
Goudelet, G-U-R-U-L-E.
Well, give her a big hug from me, and you sound like a terrific young woman. Back in a moment. I'm Dennis Prager. Wow, that's a big issue. And it's a new issue in human history, children living far from parents. It never happened in history. This is brand new. And it happens in the United States more than any other country because we believe in individual freedom. Here's the way it works in life. Every blessing comes with a curse. That's just the way it is. If not every, virtually every. And most of the time, I take the blessing. And understand, if you don't like the word curse, I'm only using that because it's the opposite of blessing. Every blessing comes with a price. The blessing of American individual freedom comes with the price that people don't live near their parents. Now, in some cases, that's a blessing because the parental-child relationship is very strained. But in many cases, it's painful. I understand that. I live it. It's not my druthers. But it's a free country, and therefore people move around a lot. And it's not a country whose only ties are blood ties. It's a country in which blood ties are one type of ties, but there are non-blood ties. We are the least blood-based society in human history. That's one of the reasons that we are as good as we are. Saddam Hussein hired basically only relatives. This brother-in-law is the head of the Secret Service. These two sons are the heads of this and that. The head of the Olympic Committee for Iraq. The Iraqi Olympic team was one of his sons. By the way, he had guys who didn't win anything tortured when they came back. It's a very sick regime under Saddam Hussein. We don't have familism. That is what has kept Latin America down. The belief that the only people you can trust are blood relatives or relatives. And therefore we believe in adoption. Latin Americans don't believe in adoption. I'm going to have my child who was in my blood. Most Americans think, so what? You love your child because it's your blood? Or do you love your child because it's your child? That's what I always ask people. Say, I can't imagine if I adopted. Really? So you love the child you have or the children you have, you love them because they are your seed, not because they're your child? Why don't you tell them that? See how they react. I don't love you because you're my son or my daughter. I love you because you're my seed. See how they feel. People don't think a lot of things through.